Adding an external hard drive to a Mac is common when you need more storage. But in the world of Macs and MacBooks, external drives don't always work just by plugging them in. That's because most hard drives on the market are formatted for use on a PC straight from the factory. And in this short video, I'll show you how to prepare your new hard drive to work properly on a Mac or MacBook. Today, I'm using this 20TB drive mounted in a dock, but my instructions will work for any new USB external drive. When the drive is plugged in, I immediately see this message saying the disk you attached was not readable by this computer. This means that if I want to actually use this drive, it will have to be initialized. But before you continue with my tutorial, make sure there's nothing on the storage device you want to keep, because what I'm about to show you will erase everything on it. My drive is brand new, so I'll click initialize. On the next window, I'm presented with statistics about the computer's internal storage. But I'm going to click on the name of the external drive in the left column. Now I'll click on the erase button at the top right. At this point, there are a few settings that need to be made before I continue. Here I can rename the hard drive to help me identify it later. In the format drop-down menu, there's quite a few options to choose from. If you're only going to use the external drive on a Mac, then choose Mac OS Extended Journaled. Choosing this option will not allow this drive to work on a PC anymore. Again, select this option only if you'll be exclusively working in a Mac environment. For me, I work on Macs and PCs, so for the most flexibility, I'll choose exFAT. The exFAT format will let me read and write to the drive on both a Mac and Windows PC. Then, for the scheme, leave it on the GUID partition map. And here's one last thing. It seems that when I chose exFAT format, it looks like my drive name had to be shortened, so I'm just going to make a minor adjustment before continuing. Remember that what I'm about to do will completely erase the drive, so be absolutely sure there's nothing you want to keep on it. Okay, now I'll click Erase to start initializing the disk. And even though this is a 20TB drive, the formatting process took less than 10 seconds. Now I have a fresh empty external hard drive I can use to store stuff on. If this video was helpful, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all my weekly videos.